Hi everyone, welcome to another very excited video about Octane Blender. Today's tip is about to remove these imperfection seams over here, as you can see, using a very interesting technique that Octane Blender has that is called Triplanar. So let's get started. Okay, so let's take a look on the model first, so you can see what's going on over here, and then we can create the material from scratch. Okay, so let me show you how are the UVs in this model. Here you go. As you can see, I didn't open up the UVs correctly, because it would cost me a lot of time to do that, as you know. So I use actually this guy over here to open it up, the Smart UV Project. Okay, so this guy is a very useful tool to do this kind of job. Again, this is not like the perfect UV opening, but it can help you save a lot of time if you use the Triplanar node. So let's take a look on the material. Let me reset it. Okay, so what I have here is a universal material and my bitmap. And if I plug it on the albedo, this is the result we got. So as you can see here, close to the edge, we start having these imperfections. And this is a very ugly imperfection, and it happens most of the time when you open the UVs like that. And to solve this problem, we are going to use the Triplanar node from Octane. So if you search for Triplanar, this is the guide that you're going to use. And if you search again for Triplanar projection, this is another part of the node that you're going to use. So to make the magic happen, what you have to do is to plug the Triplanar map on the albedo. And here we have the bitmap that you're going to plug it on the positive X, negative X, positive Y, negative Y, positive Z, and negative Z. So as you can see, nothing happened because we still have to do some work to adjust it. So the next step is to plug the Triplanar projection on the projection of your texture. And now you have to plug another node called transform value that you're going to plug it on the transform of your texture. And now I'm going to scale the texture up a little bit, so something like that, 10, maybe a little bit more, 20, a little bit more, 35, yeah, that's a good number. Okay, so let's take a look, let me see if I can find, yeah, here's another one. As you can see here, we have another imperfection in this part here. So how the Triplanar map works. Here we have the blend angle, and this is the guy that is going to smooth out the entire bitmap, as you're going to see right now. So if I increase this number, you can see that it start to blending one part of the texture to another. So if I set it to 0, we have this sharp edge over here. And if I start increasing the blend angle, it starts to blend the texture together. So it's very, very helpful actually, because for models that are far away from camera, or you are not going to make any close up of this model, it can help you to save time instead of open up the entire UVs by hand. And as you know, it takes a lot of time, and using this Triplanar, you save you a lot of time of texture. So this guy is it's a very, very nice guy, and you almost can see the imperfections happening on the edges. Let's try to find the first one here. Yeah, it's around here. So if I increase it, it starts to blending together all these pieces. So this is very, very helpful again. So I hope this video could help you somehow. This is, again, one of the techniques I use most of the time when I don't want to open up UVs. And this, I think, will definitely help you on your workflow as well. Okay, so that's it, guys. Thank you very much. I appreciate you are watching it. And if you have any tip, any ideas for new videos, please let me know. I'll be glad to record new videos to explain new things for you guys. And yeah, that's it. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video.